seems pleased with Danny's new choice of outfit.
Beautiful. They are so pretty.
Put them on.
I'm quite nervous about it, I think.
Why?
Joe, talking about what this was like last year, I'm beginning to be a little bit nervous because I thought it was just going to be a party with red and pink performing, and it's not at all, is it?
She wore a rubber dress that got ripped off her.
Yeah. Do you think it's going to be quite full on?
I think that's the point of a fetish party.
Okay. Okay, we should probably go because otherwise I might bottle out.
Welcome to the jungle, baby!
The girls waste no time getting stuck into the action.
It's amazing. It's a whole new world.
What?
I'm really bad. I haven't checked. But I've got 3 10-minute checks.
Tell us to come. Tell us.
Yes, come.
Meanwhile, Danny is giving her critique of the night.
Well, I'm sorry, but it's not as good as Antichrist.
Yeah, it's not as good as I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
I was expecting
the dungeon
was
that really bit where everyone's having sex. Imagine a whole room and like everybody
having sex.
Like
it's not.
Get some stamps, please.
Despite having a classroom of kids to teach the next day, Jo's decided to drop in on the fetish night.
These are my friends. These girls. These are the bar staff at G Spot. And my fucking pussies. These are my bitches. And they've just been getting me drunk all night.
Yeah,
which is a great addition to the painkillers for the tattoo.
That's all it is
in the tonight's quiet. I'll probably have a little swirl on the pole and hopefully that'll liven things up. And we're going back in the dark room. I got spanked. I'm inappropriately touched.
Barrister Daisy might be used to donning a wig, but this is a very different scene. Whilst Daisy's been enjoying herself, Joe's feeling neglected and increasingly frustrated.
That's why you're calling a cab and going home.
I'm calling a cab and going home because I'm supposed to be trying to be a primary school teacher. I have to get up in like 5 hours' time to teach small children. I'm here for you. Not because I want to be, I'm here for you. I'm here on no sleep after having a fucking shitty ass tattoo for you. You want to cause a drama and argue with me about it? Fine, I'm here for you.
Don't tell me that there are other hot girls here.
So
she's overtired. She shouldn't have come. And now she's taking it out on me, that's all.
Meanwhile, Danny and her mates have decided to call it a night.
I came here to have fun. I came here in a good mood. I came here at whatever time in the morning, despite the fact that I have to get up in a few hours' time and be a sensible teacher. I came here as little Joe, really excited to have fun with you, and you ignored me.
It doesn't have to be this hard, but it always is. So what, that's your conclusion? You're just walking away?
I'm really sorry.
Don't apologise. You two need to talk and...
She won't talk to me. She won't talk to me. I really don't know what to do.
It's the morning after the night before, and Jo needs to put the trauma of last night behind her. Today, she's hoping to use her drama training to enthuse a group of kids. It's running workshops like this that she hopes will help her secure a teacher training place.
Considering I had quite a late night, or rather early morning, I feel better than I probably should. Might not have been the most sensible idea before having an early morning drama class with small children. Is rock and roll.
Good morning, Miss Davis.
Good morning. What we're going to do is pass some energy around the room. So you're going to pass it to your neighbour by saying zip, like that. Yeah. All right?
Zip. Point.
Feeling a little lost, she relies on some props.
Who's going to be the pilot for the aeroplane? And who's going on holiday? Come on, someone must want to go on holiday. Do you want to hold my cat? Are you scared of my cat? Can you hold it just for 2 minutes while we do the play? Please, for me. And for everybody else in your play, because they need a cloud and you make a very good cloud.
Hold it for 1 minute.
For 1 minute. Okay, it's a deal. Right. You ready? I'm not winning. I don't like children. Where's my cloud? Come on, we had a deal. 1 minute as a cloud. Come on. Reconsidering my career choice.
I think Miss David was good.
I think she was a bad teacher.
I think she's sort of in the middle.
So I still have a little bit of conflict inside me. I'm still half DJ and half primary school teacher. I probably had one too many drinks last night. But yeah, it's going to be one or the other, not both. If I get in the classroom and it's 2 years down the line and I'm still like this, then okay. I'll put the chalk down.
A few days later, Jo's at Middlesex University. She's about to have the most important interview of her life for Teacher Training College.
I've worked really hard to get myself to this place where I'm studying and going to change my life. So I don't get a place on this PGCE course, I will be devastated.
Jo's dreamt of this moment for the last 3 years.
Heart's starting to race and I'm starting to feel a bit sick.
She needs to impress a room full of teachers.
I've got to get this.
After 5 hours of group exercises, interviews and tests, Jo's finally out.
I think I'm still shaking. I wasn't prepared for the fact that there was going to be a maths exam or an English exam. So that was fun. But I aced the maths test. I'm going to go and get drunk. I've got a gig tonight, perfect. I'm going to go get drunk, a DJ, and at least I know that if I don't get on this course, I've got something to fall back on that I'm quite good at.
Coming up... the Candy Bar Girls go ghost hunting. Shabby has organised a ghost hunt and has roped in her brother Wade to help her.
You guys that don't know me, I'm Wade and I'm a paranormal investigator, and tonight we're here to help you investigate.
I've heard some pretty heinous stories relating to the candy bar of things that go bump in the night, as it were.
We're going to see what seem to be the most active areas of the building.
Because my brother kind of is into that paranormal investigation thing, that's what he does. I thought I'd get him down and see if there's any truth in it. I think he thinks he's the new Yvette Fielding.
I'm telling you now, sir, if anything happens,
you'll
I'm
be
handing you my notice before I come in tomorrow, because I'm not opening this place on my own.
Alex is back from her romantic trip to Paris and is feeling a little worried about the night ahead.
I am very scared. I think that some crazy stuff is going to come down tonight. I think everyone's going to end up running out of the front of Candy Bar, so I've left all the fire exits open for that reason.
Wade plunges the girls into darkness and gets ghost hunting.
Is there any ghost spirits, astral beings or orbs, if you could please make communication with us? If you are here, could you tap on something? Do anything to let us know you're in the room with us.
I heard that.
She can hear footsteps upstairs. That's her only problem.
If that was you, and it was your intention to scare, well, you've done a good job so far.
Grouped us in a fucking circle, asked to all fucking hold hands, and he was like, show yourself or touch one of us or something. And I heard a thud. Like, not like someone stomped, like a thud inside. Like, if you know, like, not like this, like a deep thud.
Did you mean a thud?
Not like a hollow, like a, you know what I mean? Like a thud. And I had to go. Like, it really freaked me out.
Alex and fiancé Sam take Wade to another area where the spirits have allegedly been heard.
A lot of girls say they've seen hands coming under or have heard things like...
Yeah, if you move that, up, I'm going to go in there and lock the door. Does anyone want to volunteer to go in the other cubicles?
No.
Okay, well,
we have our staff toilets.
If the girls have been freaked out before by being in here, let me...
Fuck off! What the fuck was that? And it came from that toilet. Not even being funny.
If the sound just came from in here and no one moved, do it again while I'm in here. Go on.
Whatever was going bump in the toilets, probably nothing, has moved on. So the hunt continues in the basement.
If there's anything here with us today, any ghosts, spirits, astral beings, or orbs, could you please give us a sign? Please do anything to let us know you're in here.
Oh my God!
I don't know, but I heard it. And it wasn't any of us.
No, fuck off! Fuck off!
Do it again if that was you. Come on. Don't back out on us now.
The girls outside the cupboard think they've seen a ghost eye on the door.
Right, I need to open the door for 2 seconds. Right, there's a hole right here, yeah? Is anyone holding a light in here?
There is, something kind of there, it is, God, there, it is there is,
there yeah. is! Right.
Now it's gone.
No, it's an eye. It's like, you know, like a cat's eye.
In you go.
Fucking hell.
If that was you, do it again, come on. Bang on this door. What the fuck was that?
Tonight has actually been really far out. Every fucking phenomenon you can think of happened. Like, I'm literally not... Like, I'm vibing out now. Good cupboard. Fuck.
In central London, Jo Davis has had some news about her teacher training application.
Awesome, thank you very much. Thanks for your help. Thanks, bye. I've had an offer of a place on condition of getting a 2-2 on my current degree, which is awesome because I've got 2-1s and firsts for my work so far, so done. Yes!
Next week on Candy Bar Girls, Danny needs a new flatmate.
She doesn't like it. We're fucked.
Natalie moves to London to join her lesbian twin sister.
Freaking out. Cool, a little bit now.
And it's Valentine's Day.
She doesn't need to think about what I like, she just knows. It's amazing.
See just how amazing things get as the new series of Candy Bar Girls...